So obviously a crosshair like this can be really useful for lining up smokes and such. I'll show you the way I do it, and I'll also show you a couple simpler but less convenient ways of doing it. I configure my settings such that whenever I press my button to equip a smoke, I'm also switching to this crosshair. And then when I throw the smoke, I'm switching back to my default crosshair automatically. So I'll show you how to do that. Alright, to do this, you're going to need to edit the AutoExec file. It's going to be in your Steam folder, which is probably Program Files x86 for you. Steam Apps, where your games are. Go into the CFG folder for Counter-Strike. This is where the AutoExec.cfg is. This file will automatically execute when the game launches. So any custom settings you put in here are going to automatically be input when the game starts. If you don't have one of these in the, already in your folder, just create it from the text file. Make sure you name it a CFG at the end of it, .cfg. And it's named AutoExec, obviously. And so the first thing we'll put in there, we're going to want to create an alias for this smoke grenade crosshair thing, the big white one that I use, or whatever you want to use for that purpose. Create an alias for it. I call it CH Smoke. An alias, if you don't know, is just another name for something in this game. So after putting in this line, if I input chsmoke into the command or the console, the command console, then that will be equivalent to typing in all this stuff. So once I've made the alias for the smoke grenade crosshair, I'm just going to add that onto the end of my smoke grenade bind. So in this case, I just made another alias called that equipment slot 8 for the smoke grenade, smoke grenades slot 8, and then I added the crosshair to the end of it. And then you just bind it to whatever button you want to bind it to. And then what this will do is it'll activate the smoke grenade crosshair when you equip the smoke grenade. And then when you're done throwing a grenade, you're going to want to go back to your regular crosshair. So you're going to want to create an alias for whatever you use for your regular crosshair, whatever that is. Name it something like that. And then you're going to want to add this alias onto the end of these minus attack and minus attack 2 commands, just like I did here. I don't know if you need to unbind mouse 1 and 2, but you might as well. It doesn't hurt, I don't think. And like it says here, this will switch back to your regular crosshair when you release mouse 1 or 2, or after you throw the grenade, which is what you want. And also, you're going to want to add this regular crosshair alias to the end of your binds for, or your aliases or binds, whichever you, however you want to do it, for your other weapons. So for slot 1, slot 2, and slot 3, your knife and your 2 guns. See, what do I use for mine? I use CH default 0, which is the default crosshair with a gap of 0. Yeah. So it's just CH default 0. Nothing special there. And so let's see what that looks like in game. So when I'll equip a smoke grenade, look, it looks like one's already equipped. Okay, there we go. It equips the smoke grenade crosshair. And when I throw it, or when I release mouse 1 or mouse 2 or both, it switches right back to my default crosshair like I want for my gun. And let's say I got the smoke grenade crosshair out and I want to switch to my other gun. Well, it automatically switches to my default or to my regular crosshair when I pull out the right gun. You can also get silly like I have with like different colors for each grenade, but not necessary. Okay, so there's a couple other ways you can get this smoke grenade crosshair to pop up and go away whenever you like, but they're not quite as convenient, but they are simpler. So this first way is you can set it up so that you bind a button, in this case V, to activate the smoke crosshair whenever you're holding down the button. So when you hold down the button, the CH smoke is activated, and when you release it, your regular crosshair comes back on. So let me just put these settings in the game real quick. Config folder. Let me just name this hold. Okay, let's go into game and pump those settings in. I'm gonna call it hold. Okay. So now when I hold V, yep, and when I release it, it goes away. So I mean that's kind of useful, I guess. And see, the other way would be to do it this way, to have it toggle on and off. I know there's an easier way to do toggle commands, but I never quite get them right. But this will definitely work. In this case, you're gonna bind a button to be your toggle button. So let me try these commands. I'm sure this will work. Call it toggle. Okay. Same trick again. And let's see now. No. Oh, there it goes. Yep. I had it set up so it starts off, or it starts on, so it toggles off right away. Oh, so that's another way to do it.